Chibi-Robo, please. Our power bill was $8,000 this month. We had to sell most of Bart.
Kabanga. Yes, this video is explicitly inspired by this bizarre meme. Because really, how much would having a little robot running around your house 24/7 actually raise your electric bill? This is exactly what I was determined to figure out. But friends, doing so would require me to do something that most people on this planet haven't done. Actually play Chibi-Robo. Before we get into the math, let's briefly get some extra context. In Chibi-Robo, you play as Chibi-Robo, one of many robot helpers taking the globe by storm. Your goal is to generate as many happy points as possible by cleaning and solving tasks for the Sandersons, the family you're part of. It's not all peachy though, because throughout the game, Chibi appears to be significantly increasing the Sandersons' power bill. And at the end, Faux News accuses the tiny robots of placing a significant amount of strain on the country's power grid. The power bills and the power grid are the two problems we'll be tackling today. The main issue with calculating Chibi's power usage is that we aren't exactly given any concrete numbers. We do have his battery, and you would think that would be crucial, but that's just how much power he holds. My hypothesis is that regardless of its size, his power consumption should remain about the same every day. The only difference is that you can plug in less often with a bigger battery. However, we also aren't given this power drain, so we can't immediately jump to calculating. So we need to figure out how many watts Chibi uses in a day. Luckily, there is a way to do this. Manually. Yeah, I reviewed all the footage of me playing and counted how many watts were used before I plugged into an outlet, put them all into this spreadsheet. Ultimately, the truth is somewhere between my initial instincts and my hypothesis. As we can see, as the game goes on and Chibi's battery gets bigger, his power usage does go up. The reason for this is that having a bigger battery allows him to exert more energy on more expensive actions more often, such as opening doors, using ladders, and shooting his gun. Simultaneously, at a certain point, it does seem like the energy usage levels out and stops increasing, because the battery capacity still isn't equal to power draw. The final thing to note is that you can manually set how long half a day is at 5, 10, or 15 minutes. Obviously, the longer days would result in a higher watt count. I still went with 15 minutes because I thought it would more accurately reflect the length of a real day. Also because it was my first playthrough, and I have no clue why you wouldn't play with the 15 minute days. Regardless, I still checked how many watts I used during a 5 minute section when my battery could only hold 80 watts. I ended up using 171 watts during this half day, which seems to be about in line with cutting the other days by 2/3. Also, some of the data got kind of spotty towards the end because you unlock the ability to sleep, which fast forwards to the next day or night. Overall, the data should be good, since the majority of days are valid and the non-valid data generally lines up with what is valid and is just incomplete. With that out of the way, we can kick out the outliers and average out the power consumption to figure out how much Chibi uses in a day. Some days are more intensive than others, but on average, he uses about 930 watts per day. Now we can begin figuring out his monthly cost. I'm going to quickly put a disclaimer right here. I'm not proclaiming myself to be an expert in electricity or anything. I have put in a lot of research and effort for what should be a simple task, and I'm pretty sure all my math and formulas are correct. But maybe there are some complex factors which have been left out. I am also trying to convert video game mechanics to real life, which is something you should probably never ever do, but we're doing it today for the sake of fun. With that said, in order to calculate the cost, we can multiply his daily kilowatt usage by the days in a month times the cost of a kilowatt. We just found out that his watt usage is 930 watts per day, which would be 0.93 kilowatts. Next, there are 30 days in a month. Crazy, I know. As for the cost, well, that depends. Quick fun fact for all the 10-year-olds out there. Electricity costs different amounts in different places. Luckily for me, it appears the game takes place somewhere in suburban America, which is really convenient, because now I don't have to worry about currency conversion or figuring out the rates in foreign countries. Now, where in America is a harder question to answer. I tried looking around, and it's not very clear. I mean, there's grass in the backyard, so we can rule out the desert. I don't see any, like, mountains either. Overall, it's pretty ambiguous. So I decided to just average the cost from every state and use that. But hold your horses, because we can't just use the cost from today. Chibi-Robo came out in 2006. You know, before all the recessions. Luckily, I found this chart which contains the rates for each state in 2006, and after averaging it all up, the cost of electricity would be about 9 cents per kilowatt hour. That figured out, we can get back to our equation. Just how much would Chibi-Robo add to the Sanderson's electric bill every month? Drumroll please. $2.51. Hey, don't click off yet, there's more video! Thanks. Maybe subscribe while you're at it. Now, I can't imagine $2 a month would break the bank for the Sandersons. For comparison, $2 is around the amount that certain small appliances would use today. Something like a light bulb or even certain ceiling fans. It's also way under how much a HVAC unit or water heaters use, which are generally the main contributors to electric costs. Another funny dimension to this is that this number isn't even how much Chibi costs for a playthrough of the game. If we add together all of the watts I used in total, we get 12,554 watts. Divide that by 1,000 to convert to kilowatts, then multiply by 9 cents, and the cost of my playthrough totals just under a dollar and some change. A measly amount of electricity considering all the happy points I generated. So overall, Chibi-Robo is most comparable to a fluorescent light bulb in electrical use. Despite what everything in the game suggests, he absolutely shouldn't be ruining the Sandersons' finances. So why are they in such disarray? It's the dad. The dad did it. Turns out Chibi isn't the only fancy overpriced toy he recently picked up. He's been buying a lot of action figures, whilst also hiding the receipts. Bad news for him is Chibi cares more about happy points than hiding dirty laundry, so he went right ahead and reported that to mom and... Oh, this cartoon character is going to divorce her husband. Now seems like a great time to address the other main accusation. At the ending of the game, Bo News says that every household having a Chibi-Robo is significantly increasing the strain on the power grid, and their continued existence could lead to disastrous results. And, no? I looked around a little, and the most prominent statistics I found seem to suggest the average American household uses around 900 kilowatts per month. Of course, this number will wildly vary by state, and this is also the present number, not the stats from 2006. Regardless, each household using an additional 28 kilowatts per month would certainly increase the overall strain on the power grid, but I don't think it would be disastrous, especially since the Chibi-Robos would naturally be rolled out in a gradual fashion. Not every house would even have one, and the grid would have time to adapt. If that analysis seems a bit too vague for you, there is another point to consider. Most Chibi-Robos just suck. They're bad at their jobs and are probably turned off. I say this because of the in-game ranking. You see, the robos are all judged by a universal ranking, based on how many happy points they've collected. The more points, the higher your rank. At the start of the game, you easily blow past the first couple hundred thousands, meaning they haven't done much. I suppose it's possible all these robots are still burning electricity and their owners just have some issues that run so deep that a toy can't fix them, but honestly, I think that's just a skill issue. Additionally, the battery upgrades and some complex objects are tied to going up in rank. Again, although capacity isn't consumption, we discover that having a higher capacity allows for more exertion in the same amount of time. Most robos are probably consuming even less electricity than the one we play as. On the other hand, the Chibi-Robos who are good at their job are really good. I present to you a side tangent on what it takes to crack the top 5 in the rankings. Full spoilers ahead. Let's say you're an aspiring Chibi-Robo who wants to try and reach rank number 1. So you work your ass off, clean up literally every square inch of the house, and help not just your family, but also their inexplicably alive toys with literally every single task they could possibly demand of you, while never complaining or refusing at any point. You perilously traverse dangerous environments to reach dusty corners of the home, just to find that one oddly specific item someone needed. You even encounter alien lifeforms, take care of their sickness, and use their technology to travel back in time. Why are you going back in time? Well, this nectar-addicted teddy bear has a special flower which takes 10 years to grow, and he needs to satisfy his addiction. By the way, yes, I ignored the cost of all the time travel plugins for this video. Forgive me, I didn't know how they would factor in at all. Then, your household comes under attack by evil spider robots, which you successfully defend your family from, while also saving their marriage! And after all that bullshit which you've had to deal with, you're gonna end up at, like, rank 4. At this point, I have to assume that Chibi-Robo number 1 had a part in solving the Cuban Missile Crisis. Sorry for the tangent, I just needed to get that off my chest. Back to the whole power grid thing. Funnily enough, if we are talking about Giga-Robo, then it would definitely be true. See, Giga is the precursor to Chibi, and the Sandersons actually have one turned off in the basement. This guy's battery holds up to 10,000 watts. If that thing has to be recharged at all regularly, it would seriously wreak havoc on the electric bill. And if every household had one, that would be a straight-up crisis. So are Chibi-Robos truly straining the power grid? I highly doubt it. And also have another theory. Before we get to that though, I really have to recommend this game. Because in some ways, doing the calculations for this video has been a relief. You see, the subtext while playing is that Chibi is a problem. He's bringing so much joy to all these wacky characters, but at the same time is a renewed burden on the family. Every single time you plug in, Chibi is using some of the Sanderson's money. That might sound like an overanalysis at first, but the thing is, the game actually has quite the touching story. It balances absurdity with heartfelt moments in a very compelling way, and I fully believe that the dichotomy between generating happy points and using electricity was intended by the developers. So after doing a full playthrough of that at the back of your mind, it's a relief to run through all these calculations and learn that, no, Chibi isn't a significant burden from any angle. If you ever get the chance to play this game, I'd highly recommend it. Well, with all that said, it's time for the ultimate conclusion of this video. Faux News has put out a hit piece in order to slander Chibi-Robos across the globe. These little machines would not put a devastating amount of strain on the power grid and literally generate happiness with their existence and provide relief to those who own them. There's only one conclusion I can draw from this, folks. Fox News hates happiness. Like and subscribe if you want real hard-hitting journalism at the Just Jasen YouTube channel.